Doch, I'm not watching the stream. I'm laying on my bed.
That's a good thing.
That's not a good excuse, but okay.
Excuse me.
Tuesday the 15th. Did I even change this? Oh my god. Oh yeah, here it is.
Excuse me.
Why do I feel like this guy's already on here?
I just got banned from your channel.
How'd you get banned?
I said, I'm not fat bros, and then they banned me.
Raffle Broski, unban him. Raffle Broski, how are you still awake? Don't you have to wake up in the morning?
No, I don't. Sorry, I have some stream issues. I can't unban right now. It's nothing personal.
Wait, isn't that when the thing is?
Oh my god, I'm so fucked up.
Wait, that's the 18th through the 20th, isn't it?
What date was that? Why did this guy send me 2 emails? Oh, he's killing me.
Because you didn't answer the first one. Steven was my boss at my last job.
Good.
I'm still banned.
Rafa Broski, why you still haven't banned, bro?
Type your name in chat and I'll unban you.
Oh, okay. It says I'm unbanned now.
Okay.
See.
Click the picture I linked in the Skype channel, Steven. It's the image I have as my avatar on Skype. It's pretty cool science fiction picture, and I think you'd like those.
Yeah, Steven, your mod Joe keeps banning me.
Why does Joe keep banning you?
Apparently I'm too fat, and I'm Canadian.
Oh. Okay.
Well, I mean, being Canadian is a pretty good reason to stay banned. I don't know. I'm just kidding. Joe's being mean.
Wait, why isn't Joe in this call?
Look, guys, I'm almost done. I'm so close.
As soon as I'm unbanned, I get instantly rebanned.
You're just DJ Fiddler, right?
Yeah, I'm the Fiddler.
What?
I'll type chat.
Yeah, do it.
Every time you say your name, I hear Hitler. I don't know if it's because I'm German or because you say this weird, but...
Well, I do have kind of a Canadian accent.
I hear it like Fattler. Is it just me?
Okay. Maybe I want to hear Hitler, I don't know. Sorry.
Apparently I'm now known as DJ Hitler.
Or Fattler, according to Joe.
Or DJ Fattler. Is that mixture of two?
DJ Fiddler.
The only reason my name is DJ is because my first and second name are Dakota James.
Historia
DJ, the only other person I've heard called DJ is the girl from Full House.
Oh, one of them is bringing back my old nickname, DJ Fiddledicks. they called me that the first time I called Steven.
First and time you yourself.
Dakota is a unisex name, guys. It's not a female name.
Whatever, bro.
Whatever, bro!
That's gonna go on the soundboard.
You know, it's already there.
And it's not the same one, though.
I think it is.
Wait, who made that soundboard?
I don't know. Who did make that soundboard?
I don't know. They uploaded it, though.
Something like that.
I think a guy named Merkel.
Yeah.
Merkel?
Oh, I'm just looking on the thing, and it says posted by Merkel.
Can't you have flash files as your background in Windows? Maybe Steven should have a thinking plus.
Oh my god, I'm almost done.
I'm banned again. Steven, will you give me mods so I stop getting banned from your channel?
It's on copy pasta.
No.
Think that's a good idea, Speed.
I think we have just enough with one Ashton is enough.
We need more mods, definitely. More.
What the more mods you have, the more funds you can have to get them banned.
That's true. Everybody hates me.
Oh, who is trying to BM me? Sending me an email telling me to book lessons with Mr. Bitter? Are you motherfuckers for real? Sorry.
Well played.
Wow. No, this guy wasn't trolling either. He's got a lesson set up with me. Oh, man. I'm sorry. I'm not BMing Mr. Bitter, but...
I don't know. I'm going to give him the benefit of the doubt and hope that he's talking about
Dude, 12
weeks with the pros.
No.
He better be.
It's Mr. Bitter's site for booking Zerg lessons. I'm sure it costs monies, but you might be interested in checking it out. No, he wants me to book a lesson with Mr. Bitter.
I don't think that's what he means. Retarded. I hope that's not what he means.
Mr. Bitter gives lessons, I'm pretty sure.
I don't know, he takes lessons.
No, I know he does lessons with the pros, but I'm pretty sure he gives them too, doesn't he?
Yeah, he gives lessons. I've seen him give lessons.
No, I know he does, yeah, because that Run StarCraft
sure
2 guy.
Is that like a Gosu coaching thing for Zergs or something?
No, because that Run StarCraft 2 guy that was helping coach me for Terran took lessons from Mr. Bitter, so I know Mr. Bitter gives lessons.
Yeah, I know, I'm just saying, are you sure it's not like a Gosu coaching thing?
No.
Like, advertise your coaching lessons?
No. I'm pretty sure this guy was BMing.
Then permaban that asshole.
Well, he's trying to get a lesson from me, so I'm not going to permaban him until after he pays me.
Oh my god.
I'll give you a lesson.
They seriously banned me again.
Fuck.
Steven, did you know that minigun charges $50 an hour for coaching?
Well, what happened to Mulu? Why didn't he answer?
How many more emails?
Wow.
Who is that?
Nothing. He just looks extremely young.
Well, I know, obviously. That's adorable.
Yes, I will be streaming the birth.
How expensive is it to have a kid there?
I'm gonna try and get I'm gonna try and stream the birth while getting the Korean like thing like as an overlay. So like as the baby comes out, it's like reaver, 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 reaver. It'll be awesome.
Flag. Are you gonna eat the placenta?
Yes.
Is it gonna go Plague?
Yep. Right when it pops.
Oh, net.
Placento!
It said I was unbanned, but then I instantly got banned again.
Hey, some dude named this guy wants to come. My creepy, everybody makes fun of his voice. This is turning into the Howard Stern show, I agree.
Well, since you're only freaking checking emails, you have to entertain everybody with this. What's up, Parker?
Nothing much, how about you?
Not a lot.
Mulu needs to talk.
Just
in
have a
chat, but he's not talking.
Why join a call if you're not going to talk, Mulu?
Because of commercials.
I've been unbanned from your room 3 times. It's actually working now.
What's your name, anyways?
My name?
Like, yeah, I'll type it in the chat on there.
He already did.
Yeah, I already did there.
Well, that was before I joined the call. Come on, Ben.
Well, yeah, I'll type it.
Magnus, is that you?
Hey, he changed his picture.
Who did?
Magnus.
I did.
Power drip.
The only kind.
Parker.
Yeah.
I want to apologize to you for hating you because of your name. I shouldn't hate you because of your name. I should hate you if you become an asshole.
Should I treat you like an asshole? Would that help?
Only if you want to. I'll stop hating on you.
You'll have to find somebody else.
Seriously, like, who keeps clearing it after I did? Like, 500 times.
It was me, I'm sorry.
I just got banned from his room. I just got banned from his room again. I didn't even say anything.
They're finding you on the chat list and banning you.
That's the reason you should be on IRC, because a clear chat doesn't do anything.
Jesus.
It's not like you can actually read up fast enough.
Somebody want to, unban me and then, like, unmod the person who keeps banning me?
No, people are going crazy right now.
I actually logged the channel and
IRC.
I've logged it since, on IRC, and it's already up to 70 kilobytes. I think that's 75. Yeah, it's more. How much is 1 kilobyte in lines, Steven? You should know this.
How much is what?
1 kilobyte. How many lines are that in Notepad? Like a raw text?
I have no idea.
Because 20... it's a set amount.
What? I have no idea. I don't know.
I'll see. I'm gonna check.
Is he googling it?
We'll check how many lines the text is and then divide it by how many kilobytes are.
Yeah. It all.
I'm due in 5 weeks.
Oh, that's like. So, what are you planning on naming it? You said you were gonna name it something unique.
Wait, you're saying
I'm gonna name it
Jadong.
I'm Jadong. I approve.
So you're not gonna name it Stephen Bonnell the Third?
No, that's.
We already had this discussion. She doesn't want to name it Stephen Bonnell III.
Name him Magnus. Seriously, Magnus.
I might name it
Magnus.
Oh,
so you can just name Stephen Bonnell II Jr. There you go.
No.
What? Stephen Bonnell. How about I name him Stephen Bonnell II? The second.
The second.
You should just call him Jimmy.
My name is
Jimmy. How about I call him Yahweh?
You should call him Jimmy! No!
Pretty much.
Oh, I'm sorry. That's not right.
What the heck?
Steven, could you unban me?
Rafa Browski's my official mod on channel unbanner.
Yeah,
but
Steven.
They just keep rebanning me. I don't even know who's doing it.
Okay, whatever. Steven.
What do you
go
want?
Go watch this.
Steven,
go watch
you
this.
Finish
I just
your
saw
emails?
The post on Twitter.
Thanks, Ruffle Broski.
Wait, you use Twitter? You could just kill yourself now.
Shut up.
Heart.
$30.
It's part of being in esports.
Dude, it is epic.
Wait. Look at the title. What?
Yeah, I know. Just, no. Steve, go watch it. Fucking
what am I watching? I'm trying to fucking do emails. What do you want me to watch?
This is more important.
What?
I linked it in chat.
Oh my
it's
God.
Half an hour. It's very, very important.
Welcome
I don't care. I just started
a
watching
show
it.
About imbalance, not for those who are fake.
Looks like another
heart,
Idra interview.
Those with
I don't know.
Egos.
Oh my God.
And I'm EG Idra. We'll be your host.
A show named Imbalance starring Idra? I think I might have to watch this. When did this get posted?
I mean,
did this get posted like right now?
You could like be a guest on that.
I could be a guest.
This is going to be an introductory episode where we talk about the show.
But you're not in Korea.
It's okay.
So many people in your chat are getting randomly banned.
Okay. Listen, I'm gonna finish. I will be ready to play after this ends. I'm leaving the Skype call because you guys all bug me. And then I'm gonna watch this, finish emails, ladder. It's gonna be lots of fun. Okay, bye.
Okay.
Steven, wait. Could you at least make it so they can't ban me anymore?
Raffle, keep on banning him. I trust you. There you go. I don't have time.
Yes, you do.
My first one's at 8. It's in an hour.
So then let's go now. Steven! No, we're going...
It's gonna be a 20 minute drive there at least.
We're going to Ivy. I wasn't actually going to. Bad about it.
What is 120 Canadian dollars? $40 is 80 and 40. This works, I guess.
Got to listen to the same one.
Three. Homer.
What?
Friday, 7:30. The 4th? The 11th? I see him. Mads L. Fuck, people need to... Should work.
Why are you growling at me?
takes a long time? What if there's a long line? You have to do your wave step. It's going to take a while. How about... And give me a list. Or you give me a list and I'll go...
I need to take some to my parents. Don't!
Why would you do that?
Introductory episode where we'll talk about the show's purpose and what exactly. Welcome to Imbalanced, the show about imbalance, not for those who are faint of heart or those. Welcome to Imbalanced, the show about imbalance, not for those who are faint of heart or those with overinflated egos. I am Artosis.
And I'm E.G. Idra. We'll be your hosts. This is going to be an introductory episode where we'll talk about the show's purpose and what exactly imbalance is.
That's right. You know, this show, we want to talk about balance because, well, let's face it, it's the most talked about thing in the StarCraft II community. You cannot go into any live report thread, you cannot read any forum thread that's more than a couple pages long without balance coming up. And, you know, we want to inform people, show you the professional player perspective because, let's face it, professional players, for the most part, avoid talking about balance because they get flamed for it.
The first issue we really want to address in this episode is what is imbalance? And an easy way to explain it is there's different degrees of imbalance. There are things that are absolutely fundamentally broken, things that just have to be patched to be fixed.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, for instance, if you look back to the beta, the Roach had 2 armor and only cost 1 supply. That was fundamentally broken. That would destroy the game if that if that were the case right now. Absolutely. Blizzard saw that. They patched it. It's gone. We don't need to think about it or talk about it anymore. Some other ones, for instance, we had original Warpgate research time. It was too fast. Protoss was too versatile.
You could actually warp in Zealots before your opponent had any units. It broke the game. It was a strategy that was better than everything else that Protoss could do. So it was the only thing that happened, and it was too hard for the other races to deal with. A lot like the original 60 HP SCV and Marine All-In. Like, a 45 HP Marine All-In is still really strong right now. And go up to 60 HP,
yeah.
Imagine that.
No.
So that had to be removed. It was removed.
Yeah, so those are some things that absolutely, hey, look at this. This destroys the game. If it were in the game now, we would be like, okay, who wants to play this game? This is wrong. This is bad. It's obvious. It's been fixed. It's been patched by Blizzard. Don't really need to talk about that anymore. What we're going to talk a lot more about are things that are possible problems, things that could change as we learn more, things that may need to be patched, may not need to be patched. And there's a lot of builds like this that we've seen through time. For instance, if we look back at the Reaper builds before the Reaper got a slight nerf, we weren't really sure. It was doing really well, and everyone thought, oh, maybe this is imbalanced. You know, not completely sure, but it seemed that way. But Zergs were actually making progress. Then a patch came out, mostly for Tubers to sure, but it definitely changed the way Reapers could be used. And now looking back at that, we can say, oh, wow, if you could still get Reaper speed before Factory, then someone like I'm MVP, someone of his level with his speed and his multitasking skill, that would not be beatable for any Zerg. So we can look back at that. We didn't know at the time, but yes, that was imbalanced.
Yeah, these are strategies that they seem overpowered right now, or they might seem overpowered right now, but they're really things that could be changed with gameplay styles and advances in player skill or understanding of the game. It's not something that's necessarily imbalanced, although it might be. Another good example is early Marine Marauder pressure against Protoss right now. It can be defended, but it's a significant investment, and a lot of times you need to know it's coming, and a lot of people think it might be too strong. And so current gameplay kind of supports that, but maybe there's a new build that'll come out. Maybe Protosses will just get better at the control necessary to handle it, and it could end up being fine in the future. That's the kind of thing that we're really going to discuss here, because it's something there's room for discussion with.
Yeah, you know, we don't know yet. Is that build imbalanced by Terran? Is that too strong? Should Protoss not have to go to such lengths to stop that? And that is something that we aren't there yet. We have to still figure out. That can be discussed to great length. Now, another thing on the other end of the spectrum, because we just showed you, the Reaper one, we didn't know at first, but yeah, that turned out to be imbalanced. And then you look at this one that we just mentioned with the early pressure against Protoss. We're not really sure. It's kind of in the middle of the road. Is this something that's going to be a problem in the future, or is this going to be figured out? But then you look at something else that, we thought it was going to be a problem, but turned out not to be. Mass Mutalisks against Protoss. For a little bit in there, way back, some of you may not remember it, it seemed like Mutalisks were way too good against Protoss.
Yeah, but given time, Protoss has discovered this safe Warpgate expand build into 5 or 6 gate Warpgate timing attack, and that just kills Mutas. Or at the very least, it takes map control away from the Zerg, which is the whole point of Mutalisks. So this was something that seemed overpowered. It won a lot of Zerg's games. Protoss had a ton of problems dealing with it. But then they found this new build that nearly nullifies it. And now it can be used. You can make Mutas against Protoss. But they're clearly not overpowered. They're just another strong strategy like anything else that you want to be in the game.
Yeah, it's kind of an evolution of playing. Protoss is understanding the matchup a little bit better. And getting past that, was that imbalance? No, it wasn't. So those are some examples of what imbalance really is. But notice this is at the pro level. And we need to talk about this for a moment. We can only really talk about balance at the pro level.
Yeah. There can be unfairness at low level, in low level play. There can be things that are easier to execute or harder to execute, and that can create a disparity in what you really need to do to win a game. But the problem is that at that level, everything is so dependent on skill. There are so many factors that you can't really balance a game for all levels and still have, a high level challenging esport.
Yeah, that's very true. That's said very well, Greg. You have so many things that you can actually improve. For instance, I'm just going to make up a for instance, because I'm not Bronze League, obviously, but if you're in Bronze League, you might think, oh, you know what? The Marauder is just too good. It's imbalanced at this level. And, well, it may be unfair at that level. It might be, but the thing is, you have so many things that you can do to improve upon your play to make that a non-issue where you get above the Bronze League and then maybe there'll be a different problem. But, you know, that onus is going to be on you. We're going to be talking about pro-level play, what the actual balance is up there, because there's very, you know, limited things that these people can work on. Yeah, there's still a lot. No one's perfect yet. But you can really narrow it down a lot quicker. You know, if I look at a Bronze replay, I'm like, well, just become way better in this area, and you're going to destroy this guy's Marauder build. But at the pro scene, you know, there's some builds where you're kind of like, oh, I don't know. What can you actually do beyond what you've already done here? Mm-hmm. So that's kind of the reason we're going to be talking mostly about pro-level balance here. Mm-hmm. It's going to be the easiest to understand. It's going to be the most mapped out and the easiest to figure out.
Yeah, and really, the balance of the game itself, in theory, it's what you have when you hit a skill ceiling. Mm-hmm. And obviously no one's at the skill ceiling. Everyone can still improve. But the pro scene is the closest we have to that. So it makes the most sense to address balance from the point of view of the professional players.
Absolutely. All right. Well, I think that we've explained pretty well what balance is. You know, we've laid that out there so that people don't just come in with some crazy thought that, you know, this addresses. So, yeah, I think it's time that we actually start a little bit talking about, you know, something that may or may not be in balance. And we just going to go right into that then.
I think that
one of my favorite things to talk about as far as balance issues go is the Colossus.
Yeah, I think that's a good place to start because it's something that it gets some flack, but overall it's not really considered imbalanced. But if you look at it, especially in the mirror matchup, PvP, I think there's a lot of problems with it. I think it's really worth discussing, considering in this context.
Yeah, and we're not just talking about a Colossus. For instance, if we go back to what we were just talking about, you know, things that were broken and had to be fixed, the Roach at 2 armor and 1 supply. You could literally just sit there and go Roaches. You can't just sit there and go Colossus. We know that, okay? So that's not exactly what we're talking about here, but anyways, let's get into the Colossus and what is the deal with this guy. For instance, let's look at PVT first. I think this is the easiest one to address right now. PVT, I don't see a real imbalance with Colossus.
Yeah, PVT kind of demonstrates the way the Colossus, and really anything in the game, should be. It's a pretty good counter to bio. It's really, really strong against Marines. It's good versus Marauders, especially with Sentry support. But then Terran can get to Vikings, and Vikings can do just fine versus Colossus. So it really then just comes down to whether or not, or whoever has the better control and the better army composition, and who really executes better. It's not a fundamental problem.
Yeah, think of what you've seen in top level Protoss versus Terran games. When you actually see Colossus builds in macro games, it's a very back and forth game. You don't just say, oh no, he has Colossus, this is looking bad. You know, it's not like that. It's a very back and forth game, as I just said here. You know, it has a lot to do with your army composition, your micro, you know, who can get the strategic advantage. So I see no problem with Colossus in PvT right now. You know, maybe it will be in the future, maybe it'll be under power in the future. We don't really know right now, but I think we can put PvT to the side burner and talk about the other two matchups, namely ZVP.
Yeah, with ZVP, it attempts to be what TVP was. You start out with Hydras and Zerglings and Roaches, and then eventually there's enough Colossus that really the ground damage, the DPS, just gets so high that you can't fight it on the ground. And so then theoretically you get Corruptors, which is supposed to serve the same role as the Vikings, and just, you know, to counter the Colossus. But the thing is, Corruptors aren't as good as Vikings. So they don't have less range, less mobility. They deal a lot of damage, so they deal the bonus versus massive. But it's a matter of actually getting there and getting in good position and killing them before your ground army is gone. And most of the time, that just doesn't happen.
No, it doesn't. You know, the Colossus forms a lot of problems for the Zerg player. Thing is, it gets into this Protoss death ball, and it just deals massive amounts of splash damage. Now, Zerg obviously is supposed to overrun with huge amounts of units. As you said, the Corruptors, there's some issues with Corruptors countering Colossus. Yeah, there are games that we see absolutely like, oh, wow, this was perfect Corruptor. But I'm talking a better unit composition overall for Colossus in this case. For instance, some of you may have seen some In Control Protoss vs. Zerg games, and he loves to go heavy Stalker, and then one Robo-Colossus at least just to start, and get more of an economy. He doesn't get too aggressive, get some more bases, and that's when the Colossus becomes the most scary.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, if you go two Robo-Colossus and you really focus on them, that's a lot of the time, that's actually when it seems the most imbalanced, because you get this big ball of 6 Colossus or so with some Warcade army support. And if Zerg doesn't have 12 Corruptors, they just get rolled because the Colossus are so strong. But if you do have a bunch of corruptors, then you can hold it just fine, because there aren't enough stalkers to actually protect them. But when you play a more robust style, like In Control does, with just the one robo and you build up Colossus over time, then you're never really vulnerable to that. You can never actually just have corruptors fly in and can and kill everyone responsible for dealing damage in your army. And given that, that's where I see a real problem with it.
You know, that is a pretty hard area for Zerg a lot of times. You know, using Protoss more often recently, I really do feel if I just stay on one robotics and really keep an eye on what Zerg is doing, have good positioning, you know, have my force fields laid out right, it feels pretty strong. But what do you think about some of these different strategies that Zerg actually has to use based around the Colossus? You know, the Colossus kind of, by the way, dictates the matchup a little bit. You know, it's... You always have Colossus in your mind as a Zerg player in the matchup, like, okay, I have to be able to deal with this.
Yeah.
This is the problem.
Yeah, they can really force and engage. That's one of the biggest things I see with it. It's just they have such long range that they can always create a positional advantage for themselves, especially because of the mobility of the Colossus. It can walk up and down cliffs. It can walk over units. It's really fast, and it outranges everything Zerg has. So they just run forward, they pick at your army, and then they pull back into the defensive position they have set up, and you can't catch them, especially if it's not on creep. So that really forces Zerg to always be thinking about Colossus and how to respond to it. And really right now there's the kind of two main ways to do it. You can either go three-base Broodlord, because Broodlords are one of the things that can deal with the range, they can deal damage to that army, and obviously their air units. And the other is kind of this mass base, very corruptor-heavy. You try and send in one wave, use the corruptors to kill off the Colossus, and then remax on units to kill the much weaker gateway army.
You know, speaking about the Broodlord build first, I know that there was a couple weeks in there where myself, you, Rhett, we were all doing Broodlord rushes because it seemed like, okay, this is how you stop a Colossus-based army. But that kind of went out of style.
Yeah. As Protoss has caught on, they realize, you know, Blinkstalkers can deal with Broodlords, and even the strength of the Broodlord, it can't actually break that army. The Colossus are just so strong that if you bring in your ground army too and actually try and do a full frontal attack, it just all dies before the Colossus do. So that was kind of passed off. You know, if it catches them off guard, you can still break them. You have that little timing there where they don't have Void Rays, which is another thing. The Void Ray buff versus Massive now means the Broodlords aren't nearly as good. But if you get there before they have Broodlords, before they have Blinkstalkers, then you could break them. But it was kind of gimmicky. There's not much economy to support it.
Yeah.
Not great production. Not great ground upgrades. So basically, you had to break them. Protoss has caught on. That kind of fell out of style. So the thing that's a lot more robust right now is the mass unit style with a lot of corruptors.
Yeah, no, I like the mass unit style. What this normally comes down to is, as the Protoss timing push is coming with like a huge army, it's just about maxed out to hit the Zerg. Zerg obviously already going to be maxed out. They do max out quicker than Protoss. But it's going to be a Roach, Zergling, Hydralisk composition that kind of overmakes Corruptors a little bit. Because you really, the focus of this army is to soften up Protoss and kill off the Colossus.
Yeah, because since the Colossus, as we're trying to say here, is really, really strong, you just have to focus so much of that first attack on actually killing the Colossus. You just have to invest almost everything in Corruptors.
Mm.
But that makes your ground army a lot weaker, both in supply and resources. So there's this really dangerous timing where even if you do kill all the Colossus, then their warp gate units, their support units, can just come in and kill you before you're capable of really remaxing and getting a sufficient army to fight off the second wave.
Yeah, that's actually very interesting, because now it comes down a little bit, because this is basically the top style that should be used theoretically in a macro versus macro game where no crazy cheesy stuff happened early. That's what we're talking about here. That stuff obviously changes everything.
Yeah.
But a lot of that depends on the map,
yeah,
which is something that we have to take in consideration for the Colossus, because on some maps, the Colossus is not going to be as good against Zerg as on other maps. For instance, this style that we were just talking about, you know, you're only on about four bases, and you try to engage the Protoss as far up as you can, to take out all that as much as you can, so that when your army is dead and you're remaxing out, he can't just walk in and do that killer damage. So, for instance, this might be a very good strategy for Shakura's Plateau, but if you look at Steps of War, this is not a strategy you can actually use there to deal with the Colossus. The Broodlord one is going to come into play much stronger on that map.
Yeah, it's much better, because, you know, like we said, it all comes down to the attacking distance. You have to engage them at their choke. But on Steps of War, even engaging at their choke means that their Stalker army is going to be in your choke about 10 seconds later. and that's just not enough time to remax your army. And also you have cliffs all over, you have a very tight contained position, and that makes broodlords better, because they really have to have the ability to dance around, to blink up and blink back and run away to deal with broodlords. Yeah. So in that situation, it's a much better option.
Yeah, yeah. It's actually, the more we talk about it, the more I become even more convinced than I was before that a lot of it is map-based. You know, if it's a much longer map, a much more wide-open map, you can't create, as you said earlier, a lot of times these Colossus armies, they'll go in and poke a little bit and then fall back to a defensive position. You know, use force fields well, use their positioning well, their long-range units well. But on a longer, more wide-open map, they're not going to be able to do that as much. So is it a possibility that on some maps, Colossus aren't even the right choice? I don't know. It's getting a little bit wishy-washy in here, where we're like, well, is this unit in balance? Maybe on the current map pool? Mm-hmm. Maybe on current maps? But what do you think about that?
Personally, I think it's clearly overpowered on the current map pool, or most of the current map pool. The shorter maps, or the more defensive maps, like Blistering Sands, it's really easy to split in half and control the expansions. Anything where there's a reasonably short distance, I do believe they're overpowered, because the only way to deal with the Colossus is to overmake the Corruptors, and, you know, overmaking means that you're not prepared to deal with anything the Corruptors don't counter, so the whole ground army. So any time where that can get close to your base before you have a bunch of Hydras again, I think the Colossus is overpowered.
Yeah, that's actually a pretty good point, because even if you look at, and a lot of this is actually getting a little bit away from the Colossus, a little bit into maps, but even if you look at StarCraft 1, obviously the siege tank, the king ranged unit of the game, and this actually made it so that short maps, tiny maps, were overpowered for Terran in StarCraft 1. Likewise, StarCraft 2, something like this, a very long range unit where you can actually just kind of siege your opponent a little bit, if I can call it that. It's not exactly sieging, because you're not like attacking into, you know, a fortified position necessarily. Mm-hmm. But, what do you think about that?
Yeah, that's another really good point, because, like I said at first, one of the worst parts of the Colossus for the Zerg player, and the thing that really makes us focus on it, is just the fact that it can control the game so well if you just have a ground army. Because it can always pull you back into force fields or something, or a position where you're just never going to win as a Zerg player. Terrain is too important, being able to flank, and really just to engage with your entire army. And your entire army is usually going to be really big as a Zerg player.
Yeah.
So the fact that they can kind of control the positioning, Zerg can't deal with that. So on a short map, where there are all those good positions for them to take advantage of, where it is so easy for them to do that, yeah, that's another really big problem with the unit.
Yeah, it definitely does seem so. Well, ZVP, what is your final opinion, Hydra? Is the Colossus too good for this matchup?
I think it is too good. Actually, it's something we haven't mentioned before, but just the fact that almost every PvZ revolves around it, I think that in itself is bad. Even if the Colossus has to be that good for PvZ to be balanced, it creates for one-dimensional style play, and it shouldn't be that much better than everything else. But yes, I do think it is too strong. I think it makes the matchup Protoss favored, except on the really big maps where you can deal with it with that macro style.
Now we have to jump back and think for a moment about the Mutalisk style against Protoss that originally people thought it was going to be imbalanced, but turned out not to be. What are the odds that we're going to actually figure out as Zerg players how to deal with this Colossus, right, in your opinion? Being a Protoss and a Zerg, you know, I feel like a very top-level Protoss versus a very top-level Zerg on the kind of maps that we're seeing mostly right now, I don't see a lot of great ways to truly deal with this. I've tried a lot of things. I've played a lot on both sides of the matchup. What do you think?
Well,
can this be solved via something other than a patch? It might take a while to figure it out for sure, but
it could. It's the kind of thing that isn't fundamentally broken, that's for sure. It's not an SCV Marine all-in. It's not the 15-second warp gates. There definitely could be gameplay changes, or players could improve and be able to deal with it. But I think it's just clear that it has such a strong unit against ground, it has such high DPS, such range, and splash damage, that ground units are not going to be the answer to it. You have to have a huge lead to be able to overwhelm it on the ground. And then if you look at your error options, mutas are very, very good units, but their strength is either when you have a huge flock of them, then the damage just kind of builds up since they all do the bounce damage, and they have decent DPS. But for their cast, they are not good fighting units. Their strength early game is the mobility, the fact that you control everything. And with warp gates, timing rushes are always really, really strong. And as a weak fighting unit, but a strong harass unit, the timing rush is the Mutalisk's weakness. And given that Protoss is kind of built for timing builds, you can use Chrono Charge to get faster upgrades than any other race can. And then you have Warp Gates that eliminate the Defender's advantage in rush distance. I don't think muted builds are going to be an answer. So the only way I see us dealing with it is going to be figuring out a perfect mix of Corruptor versus ground unit support, and really just learning to hit that perfectly. And that's the kind of thing, it feels like it's much, much easier for Protoss to deal with that situation than Zerg. So I do think it is a problem.
Alright, so yeah, it definitely could be much easier in that situation. I mean, already it's shown itself to be easier, but there could be some sort of unit composition there. I agree with you that we haven't quite seen or tested enough where you're like, oh, I know exactly the unit combination, and things like that do happen. It takes time to figure those out. But another thing I wanted to point out, I agree with everything you said there, but maps as well. I feel like maps could play a big difference in how good the Colossus is.
Yeah.
If Zerg can get a larger flank, a larger concave on the Protoss army, then obviously it's going to have a harder time. For instance, if you can actually sandwich a Protoss army, suddenly the Colossus is not going to be nearly as good. You know, when it's hitting up just your front row, because that's all you can hit, that's one thing. But if you're hitting from multiple sides, ranged units take a lot more damage there. They really do not like to be flanked and whatnot. So what do you think about maps? I think maps could help a lot, like bigger maps, helping the Colossus specifically, not the matchup or anything like that, but specifically Colossus balance in Protoss versus the maps.
Certainly. Since it is a splash damage unit, that makes flanking it, you know, even more... Flanking is always important, but against something that's splash damage, it's just a million times more important because you weaken the strength of the splash damage a lot when your units aren't all clumped up. And I know we're focusing mostly on the Colossus, but you can't really ignore the existence of force fields. So I think maps would actually have to be unreasonably big and spread out.
Yeah.
I think it would damage the rest of the game to make a map so big that you can nullify force field and Colossus with just a ground army.
Yeah, no, that's quite true.
Maps could certainly help, but I think there has to be better ways to do it. I think it would be impractical.
That's a very good point right there. All right, well, I think we've talked about ZVP Colossus enough. I want to go to PvP real quick. And you might be thinking, wow, well, imbalance in a mirror matchup, that doesn't make a lot of sense. But hear me out. Obviously, PvP at the very top level is going to be almost all 4 Warp Gate versus 4 Warp Gate right now, and some of that has to do with maps, obviously. The smaller your ramp, the more likely you're going to see a tech game. If you only have one ramp, obviously. If you have two ramps, you're always going to see 4 Warp Gates. But let's say you live past those 4 Warp Gates, and I know that probably happens to a lot of you a lot of the time, and then it normally turns into a Colossus battle, and it's almost purely about Colossus, so much so that for a little bit there, it seemed like just pumping out Zealots and Colossus while expanding was the right way. All your gas on Colossus, all your extra minerals on Zealots just to take up Colossus shots and, deal a little bit of damage. But it would mostly be Colossus to the point where it's now morphing a little bit and Void Rays are coming into the mix. So you need to get enough Colossus to make sure that, any Stalkers they have are taken out. Yet not too many, because you need to buy a lot of Void Rays, because Void Rays own any heavy, just ground attacking units.
Mm-hmm.
What do you think?
The fact that the Colossus is so important within the mirror matchup, I think that kind of just demonstrates, it's something I mentioned a little bit, how the Colossus is so important in PvZ kind of demonstrates that Protoss isn't particularly well designed. You shouldn't be that focused on one single unit. It shouldn't be that important relative to everything else. And the fact that PvP is so Colossus heavy, just that the only real variance is Void Ray, which is kind of a niche counter unit. It's anti-massive, it's flying, so it's a very specific counter. And the fact that the only thing you see is Mass Colossus or a specific counter to Colossus kind of, to me, makes the point that the Colossus is way too important to the Protoss army, and it's too much stronger than everything else Protoss has.
You know, I feel like this could maybe change somewhat in PvP. PvP, I feel, is still evolving a little bit. The 4 Warp Gate thing is like this hard hurdle to get around, especially on some of these maps like Scrap Station, like Blistering Sands. You don't see as many games that go to expansion on those, obviously, because it's easier to attack with 4 Warp Gates up the ramp. And, you know, that's just the way it is right now. But I could see it changing a little bit. You know, I think the Void Ray starts to show some holes in Colossus builds in PvP. And as those holes emerge, we're going to see less Colossus, and thus it's going to become kind of a circular rock-paper-scissors type thing where, oh, you only have a medium number of Colossus, but you're making, you know, more Stalkers to take out the Void Rays, that means that I can maybe mix in some other units as well. You know, maybe throw in Zealot, Stalker, Immortal, something like that, you know, to really take out those units very quickly. So, I don't know, I feel like PvP is still going to be able to evolve maybe out of that a little bit, but yeah, it's quite Colossus-focused.
Yeah, ideally it could end up like PvT, where you do have that balance. It's like, Colossus is better, it beats Bio, it counters it, but then you have the Vikings that can come in and deal with the Colossus, and the Vikings have their own counter, which is Stalkers, and Bio is better than Gateway units, so you get that rotation, and it all comes down to how well you balance it and how well you control it. Ideally, PvP ends up like that, but if, as I said, or if, as I feel, the Colossus is too strong, then it will end up being more Colossus-focused, just like PvC is. So, really, just have to wait and see how the matchup develops.
Yeah, alright, well, I think we've summed up our primary thoughts on the Colossus. I'm sure we could talk all day on this subject.
Yep.
I'm not completely sold on the imbalance. I feel it might be a little bit more powerful than it should be. Mm-hmm. But we may see some evolution on that. We'll have to keep on looking at that.
It's certainly possible you can find a balance between Corruptors and Ground Army, maybe some Infestor usage. I know Rhett's actually been experimenting a lot with Infestor usage, so something could develop, but I think in the current state of the game, it's definitely too strong.
Yeah, it does seem so. All right, well, I hope that you guys liked the first episode of Imbalanced with Hydra and Artosis.
Yeah. This was a bit of an introductory episode. Everything else from here on out is going to be much more like the Colossus discussion. And we're also going to be taking questions from the users, or viewers. If any of you have any questions or anything you want to discuss about Balanced, feel free to email us at imbalancedshow@gmail.com.
Yeah. That's imbalancedshow@gmail.com. Are there, like, arguments that you and your friends are having about the balance that you really want some pros to go over? You know, maybe there's something that you're always seeing on the forum, like, oh, ZergQQ LOL or something, you know, whatever. We know that, I mean, the entire community is so full of this type of thing. So shoot us out an email, and next time we're going to, you know, discuss some stuff that we want to talk about balance-wise, and we're going to go over stuff that you guys want to hear about. So, yeah, I guess that's about it.
Yep, that pretty much wraps
it up. Yeah, thanks for watching, everybody.
Oh my god! How you guys doing? So I'm definitely like 30 minutes fucking late for this dude. Somebody wants a lesson and I'm just totally standing him up. It's nice and professional. Yeah, I did get some cookies. I got some M&M cookies. I don't know if they're any good or not, though. They look like they got a lot of potential, though. Ah, fucking Jesus Christ. Yeah, I only stream lessons, that's right. Where the fuck is my dude at? Dude, I'm going to the LAN. I already got it fucking booked out. Cameron Hey, what's up?
Hey, I'm your lesson.
What are you doing? Where have you been, dude? I've been waiting for you for like 30 minutes.
I've been here this whole time.
Oh, must be a communication issue. All right, hold on.
Yeah, must be.
Okay, hold on. What race do you play? I hope you say Zerg. That's good. All right. I was just kidding. What? Okay. All right, I'm here. Are you here? Are you ready? You ready to do this?
Yep. Yep.
Good. You are on the North American server, right?
Mm-hmm.
Where are you from?
I play Australia.
Oh boy. Speaking of Australia, I'm going to the Outback to eat tomorrow. Are you jealous?
Well, I kind of eat the Outback every day, but, yeah.
No, you eat in the Outback every day. There's a big difference there, man.
Well, technically.
All right, I'm just messing with you. All right, all right, all right. Do you guys have that chain of restaurants down at your, down in Australia?
Nope.
No? All right, I didn't think so. What is this shit? Huh. All right. Are you Bunny?
Bunny? No.
Oh, I don't know why this dude just invited me to a party then. Okay. You wanna, have you added? Sorry, what did you say?
Do you want me to send you my real ID thingy?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, I'll send it in the chat.
Alright. I'm sorry, I have to ask you. How do you pronounce that last name? Wait, let me try first. I'm gonna say Bojkuk.
No, nah. It's like Bojchuk, like boy and chicken kind of thing. Yeah.
Bojchuk?
Bojchuk.
Bojchuk.
Like chicken.
Got it. Okay.
Yeah.
I tried. Alright, hold on. Did you get my request?
Mm-hmm.
Awesome.
Now, all my stats are in the Southeast Asian servers. I only really come in here for customs, but, yeah.
What's your, league?
I'm in Silver.
Cool. And what matchup do you want to work on the most?
Terran. But I haven't lost a...